ALS, Alternative Learning Systems.
Carbon market and carbon credit was in news recently. In fact, it was a major contentious issue at the COP25 at Madrid climate talks, which divided the developed and the developing world. In fact, during the discussion in the Madrid COP conference, a big issue which were yet to be resolved was the disagreement over the setting up of a new carbon market, which remained as a contentious issue like the previous issues also. It continued to be the same contentious issue. The carbon markets allow buying and selling of carbon emissions with the objective to reduce global emissions, which is an unfinished agenda. Even in the last year's meeting at the Katowice, Poland. So, when the last 24th COP meeting was held in Katowice, Poland, this was a continuous issue there also. Even now it continued. So, this is something where, you know, the market mechanism, we are talking about a market mechanism. This is to deal with the enhanced emission situation. The carbon market mechanism is considered. That means how to increase the, how to ensure that more reduction is possible. And that is how the carbon market mechanism was conceived. For example, if a developed country is unable to meet its reduction target, it can provide money or technology to a developing country project, maybe a BRIC LEN or anywhere it can reduce the carbon emission very easily, and then claim the reduction of emission as its own. So basically, a developed country will provide technology for reducing carbon emission somewhere else, and it can claim that the reduction is its own. So alternatively, a brick kiln in India or a highly polluting industry in India can make the investment and then offer on sale the emission reduction, which is called carbon credit. So if I have a company in India, and if it is a polluting industry right now, or if it is a greenhouse gas emitting industry right now, I can improve the technology, I can invest in that, reduce the carbon emission, then I can offer this for sale, which is called carbon credit. So, another party struggling to meet its own target can buy these carbon credits and show that it's their own. So, an American company who is unable to reduce the carbon emission anymore, they can buy this and show that, oh yes, I have done this much. So, carbon market existed even in the Kyoto Protocol, which was replaced. I mean, of course, the Kyoto Protocol has been replaced by the Paris Climate Accord in 2015. In fact, Kyoto Protocol 1987. So, it was there, sorry, in 1997, the Kyoto Protocol. So, that was there, and it has been replaced by the Paris Climate Accord. Now, the market mechanism which is proposed under the Paris Agreement are conceptually not very different, but are supposed to be more efficient checks and balances and monitoring and verification process. So, what was there in the Kyoto Protocol and what is there in the present Paris Accord, it may not be much different. But now it is claimed that it is going to be more efficient, more checks and balances will be there. In fact, how to set up a market, that is the next question. The provisions relating to the setting up of a carbon market is described in Article 6 of the Paris Agreement. So, Article 6 provides for a market mechanism. Article 6.2 enables bilateral arrangement for transfer of emissions. There can be bilateral agreement between two countries for transfer of emissions, emission reduction, while ensuring that they do not double count the reduction. That is very important. Suppose a bilateral agreement between Germany and India. And now, Germany will count definitely under their, total list that we have reduced this much. But India also should not be counting it, because India has, or Germany has paid for that reduction in India. So, there should not be any double counting, quite reasonable. Number two, Article 6.4 talks about a wider carbon market in which reduction can be brought and sold by anyone. So, it can be done by anybody, any market player or any company can buy and sell the reduction. Okay, so, that is 6.4. And Article 6.8, it provides for making non-market approaches available to countries to achieve target. So, it is not yet very clear what these approaches would constitute. So it is talking about a non-market approach, but what constitutes that, it is not very clear even today. But they could include any cooperative action like collaboration on climate policy or common taxation that are not market-based. So Article 6.8 talks about a non-market approach, 6.4 talks about anybody can trade in the carbon trade, and Article 6.2 talks about a bilateral agreement between two countries. So, but what are the issues? Now the issue is, why it is contentious right now? It is contentious right now because developing countries have already have many or millions of unsold certified emission reductions, CERs, certified emission reductions, each referring to 1 ton of carbon dioxide equivalent emission reduced from Kyoto regime. So during the Kyoto Protocol time, there is a mechanism called certified emission reduction. Each certified or each certificate is for 1 ton of carbon dioxide equivalent of emission reduction. So under the Kyoto Protocol, only developed countries were asked to reduce, the annex 1 countries were asked to reduce the carbon emission or carbon dioxide emission, and the developing countries were not asked to do anything. So in the initial phase, some of the developed countries were interested in buying the certified emission reduction or reductions from the developing countries like India and China, who were not obliged to make any reduction. See, during the Kyoto Protocol, India and China or the developing countries were not obliged to reduce the emissions. So they could give the certified emission reduction CERs to the developed countries. But in the last few years, most of the countries or many of the countries walked out of the Kyoto Protocol. And those remained in the Kyoto Protocol are not feeling like fulfilling the target. So because of that, the CERs demand crashed. The certified emission reduction demand crashed. And countries like India are left with projects generating CERs with no one to buy. India has about 750 million unsold CERs today. And along with other similarly placed countries, we want these credits to be valid in the new mechanism also. So we have already done many reduction. We want these CERs to be valid in the Paris Climate Accord also. So we have done under the Kyoto Protocol. Now we want this to be valid under the present Paris Climate Accord also. So, but the developed countries are opposing it on the ground that the rules and verification procedure under the Kyoto Protocol were not very robust. So they want the new mechanism to start with a clean slate. That means the new, the Paris, under the Paris Climate Accord, the developed countries are saying the old things should be forgotten, let us start fresh, which is opposed by the developing countries like India. And the second issue is that a double counting or corresponding adjustment. So the new mechanism envisages carbon credits as commodities that can be traded multiple times among countries or private parties. So there can be multiple times of trading is possible. So it is important to ensure that in this process, credits are not counted at more than one place. So if it is something is done in India, but it is paid by Germany, so who should count? Germany should count or India should count? That is the question. So whoever sells carbon credits should not simultaneously count these as emission it has reduced. So if India has sold the credit, then India cannot count that we have reduced the carbon emission. So that is quite logical. That is the developed countries argument. But developing countries argue that the country that reduced emission should be able to show it even after selling the credit at least once. And that adjustment should be made only for subsequent transfer, if any. So developing countries are saying at least once allow us to show that we have reduced it. Then in the subsequent transfer, you show it as, okay, we are transferred. So there are two contentious issues as far as the present system is concerned. One is the carbon emission, reduction, CER certificates, certified emission reductions. What to do with that? We have at least 750 million unsold certified emission reductions with India right now. We would like to use it in the Paris Climate Accord also, which is opposed by the developed countries. Developed countries want things to be start in a fresh. And the second issue is the double counting, or when something is reduced in a particular country, in a developing country, even if they have sold it, developing countries want it to be counted at least once. So these are the two contentious issues in the Madrid climate talks in the COP25. Where a final agreement was not arrived at yet. So let us hope that there will be a, in a proper understanding, and we will move forward in this direction. So this is what is meant by carbon market and carbon credit under discussion in COP 25 at Madrid.